Hey everybody, welcome back to Better Computer. My name is Matt, and today we're going to do a very quick video looking at five apps that I think Apple should just acquire and build into macOS. For most of these, it's because I think the app is awesome and it really deserves to be something that everybody gets to use. And in one of their cases, it's actually because I really don't think most people would trust a third party making this thing, and they'd rather it be done by the company who makes the platform. So it's going to be a very quick video. We're going to go over each one very quickly. Let's jump into it. Okay, the first app I think Apple should just buy and build into macOS is CleanShot X. CleanShot is an awesome tool for taking screenshots and marking them up. So I've made numerous videos about this. You can check out links in the description for more if you want, but I'm just going to take a screenshot of this part of their website to give you an idea. So the behavior is exactly the same as it is today on macOS. So it's going to be in the same spot. It's going to do the same thing. And if you just let it sit there for a couple seconds, it'll save to the desktop. But if you hover over it, there are more options. You can copy it to your clipboard without saving it. You can save it directly. You can pin it on top of other windows, or you can go into edit it. So if we edit the image, you can do a whole bunch of annotations. So a couple things, you can highlight text very easily. You can number things. So this is item 1, 2, 3. Maybe I'm writing like a task for a developer. They need to see what I'm referencing. 1, 2, 3, 4. Cool. You can do arrows. All of these can be done in a bunch of different colors. You can choose your own color. We'll go ahead and do this. Let's change the arrow type. We'll make it a fancy arrow. There you go. Let's actually make it a double arrow, so it's an arrow on both sides. We'll make it bend, and there you go. Cool. You can do rectangles, all sorts of stuff. Really awesome, really powerful. Done. Save it. Good. And now that's on my desktop, just like any other screenshot on macOS, but with a lot more power if you want it. The next app I'd think they should acquire is to fill the gap for clipboard managers. I think clipboard managers are awesome, and it's the sort of thing that makes sense to be built into the system, but for whatever reason isn't. And so let me show you a use case. Here's some links and article text that I want to bring into another document. I'm writing a blog post, for example. And so I want to say, like, this person wrote this article at this link, and here's the quote. What you can do with a clipboard manager is you can say, here's this, copy the title. We're going to go ahead and copy the URL, and I'm going to copy the text. Now, if I'm just using macOS by default, I can go over to my other document and I can paste the text that I had, but the title and the URL, I can't really access those anymore. I have to go back and copy them again. What's awesome about a clipboard manager is it saves things that you've copied to your clipboard. So if I want to bring this up, I have it set to Command, Shift, Paste, V, and it lets me arrow through the things that I've copied previously. You can see some of the screenshots we were just doing. You can see the file name. I copied that as well. And then here are the other things. So here's the link. Here's the text. So let me just paste that. There we go. And then if I want to turn this into a link, I'll hit Command K. Where's my URL? Well, it's in my pasteboard. So I can go down here, TechDirt. There we are. So now I have the link in there. I was able to just copy them and then paste them all into this other thing. It's useful for situations like this where you need to paste a couple things at once. It's also useful if you accidentally lose something. Hey, I copied this a few minutes ago and I lost it. What was it? Go back here. Ah, it was this. So like maybe I wanted to put this image down here. Let's go ahead and paste. It was this image, right? And now I've pasted that image in. Super powerful. It's one of the first things I install on any Mac because I cannot live without it. Once you get used to having it, you can't go back. This next one is an app called Rocket, and Rocket is a totally free app, and it just makes it so that you can use Slack-style emoji everywhere. So I'm in Ulysses right now, and if I hit colon, joy, there we go, the joy emoji or whatever. Ta-da, there we go. And this is just a really quick, really easy way to enter emoji. If you want to use macOS's standard way, you basically want to hit Command, Control, Spacebar. It brings up this emoji picker, and you can search and it can work, but it's a long, it's a three-key shortcut to bring it up. It's a little slower, and yeah, Rocket is just easy. It's really easy, really fast, and works awesome, and is similar to how everything works everywhere else, except for in macOS and Windows, I guess. But pretty much every app that has emoji has this built in now. Next up is an app called the Unarchiver. The Unarchiver has been on the Mac forever, and honestly, I don't know why Apple hasn't just done this as well. It basically will extract any single file type that you can think of. There's a couple options here on where you want it to extract and all that good stuff. You don't really need that necessarily, but yeah, it works great. I've got a zip file right here. I can go ahead and unarchive it. It does it really quickly, and it deleted the file for me because that's the setting I have set up. Maybe they don't want to do that. Maybe they want to keep the current archive utility, which keeps the zip for you. The one downside of the unarchiver is it only unarchives. It doesn't compress, whereas you can go ahead and compress files on macOS natively. It creates zip files there, but yeah. It's not a billion times better, but there's a little bit more functionality, actually a lot more functionality for more file types than the archive utility that's built into macOS. And I would love Apple just build this in so you don't need to use a third party to do this. And then finally, that brings us to Rewind, or Limitless, as they're now going by. But basically, the idea of Rewind specifically is that it will record your screen at all times. It can also record audio, and so you can get like meeting transcripts and stuff, but it'll basically record everything going on your computer so that you can search for it later. And it's using local AI tools to help you find the things you're looking for. You can ask questions like, when did I talk to this person about this thing? It's really powerful. It's really cool. My issues with it are twofold. Number one, that's a whole lot of trust to put in one third-party company. Hey, you can record literally everything going on my computer. Again, it's supposed to stay local, but a lot of people aren't going to trust that. They're going to trust that a lot more if Apple's doing it. The other thing that makes it a tough sell is the pricing. They do have a free option that's okay, but to get the real value from this, you need to do their Rewind Pro, which is $19 per month billed annually. So that's like $300 or whatever. And monthly, it's $29 per month if you want to pay month to month. You can see the differences here, but yeah, it's a little pricey for what it is. I ended up not paying for it because I just wasn't getting enough value from it, but it's very cool. It's just something I think that the platform holder should make. So I think Apple should acquire these guys. They also are doing their Limitless thing, which is like recording audio and like doing meeting notes. This is more of their business focused pivot maybe. But yeah, I think these guys, with the amount of trust that they're asking you for, it should come from the platform holder. I think that'd be an easier sell for a lot of people. So those are a couple things I think I enjoy. The first four, at least, are things that I install immediately on a Mac. I love them. I think they're awesome. And I would love to see those get acquired so that those guys can get a great payout, get great payday, and be rewarded even more for the great things that they've created. And everyone would get the benefit of getting these features built into macOS. So if you have any other suggestions for things you think are so good, so essential to the Mac, that you think Apple should acquire them and just build them into macOS, let us know in the comments, and thank you for watching. Bye-bye.